The Bible is a symbolic story of the progression of humanity. If we go to the very beginning, we see the story of Adam and Eve in the beautiful Garden of Eden. That's a symbol for the beautiful, pristine state of mind that humans were in the beginning. The Golden Age, or what Swedenborg called the earliest church. They lived at that time in the divine order of life. There was no separation between the levels. The direct presence of God could flow down through all their levels of mind and directly into the physical and sensory levels of their bodies. Everything was in harmony. In the earliest, heavenly sort of people, the sensory capacities of the body served the inner self obediently. And beyond that, they had no interest in those capacities. But then, as the story goes, the serpent enticed Eve to pick and eat fruit they were forbidden to eat. And Eve enticed Adam. And once they had eaten that fruit, the quality of life got drastically worse. The serpent is a symbol of the physical senses. When Adam and Eve chose to listen to the serpent's instructions, instead of instructions from God, that is a symbol of the point when humanity began to be directed by their physical senses rather than by their internal perception from God. This destroyed the original harmony and order of life, and the results are what is symbolized in the story by a curse. And Jehovah God said to the snake, "Because you have done this, a curse on you, above every beast and above every wild animal of the field. You will travel on your belly and eat dirt all the days of your life." So I'm going to head back to the studio and talk to Curtis about what this curse means.
That's an amazing portrayal that you were describing there. I feel like it's worth mentioning, right, that in biblical language, God bringing a curse actually means evil bringing a curse on itself, right?
Absolutely, but our earthly mentality might see it as God causing us some kind of trouble, but actually the trouble is sourced in that very evil itself.
Yeah, and to talk a little more about the connection between the sensory level and evil, the Secrets of Heaven 249, eating dirt all the days of its life, the serpent, means that the sensory plane became incapable of living on anything but what was bodily and earthly, so that it turned hellish. It's not like it was always bad. It was meant to be a good part of the whole, but it became hellish because it cut itself off from the divine.
Right, which then made it susceptible to suffering and decay and that kind of stuff.
And that actually, prior to that, life was possibly very, very different. This is from Spiritual Experiences 4592. If people had lived in a state of goodness, they would decline to the end of old age. And then when the body could no longer respond to the needs of the inner person, then they would pass over from the earthly body without sickness. So it seems like things were very different before evil came onto the scene.
Yeah, it seems like maybe moving to the afterlife was more like just gently shedding a layer rather than this kind of drastic ending that we now experience as death.
Yeah, so there's always some kind of shedding. There's always this moving on. You're never going to stay in the physical world forever, but it wasn't the kind of painful, isolating, confusing experience of death as we see it now.
And I'm thinking, too, that the spiritual world and the physical world were so connected that they wouldn't have the same kind of cutoff that we feel now when there's no contact with these people that have died.
Right, because we don't even know for sure if there is a life after death. For us, it feels like this person's gone, I never see him, but then they would have more visions, more communications that would kind of ease that, right?
Right, right.